What to Play presents 25 of the biggest PlayStation 5 games coming out next year, all arranged by release date. To see the complete list, check out our website at whattoplay.com, link in the description box below. This video is sponsored by Gold Inc. It's a free-to-play, play-to-earn mining simulator available for Android and iOS. More about them later in the video. Life is Strange, Remastered Collection. In this remastered version of Don't Nod's stellar episodic story-driven game, we return to Arcadia Bay to witness the relationship between Max and Chloe, bend time and make tough choices around its wonderful cast of characters. This collection also includes Deck Nine's 4-episode prequel, Before the Storm. It comes out this February 1. Dying Light 2. The sequel to the zombie parkour hybrid from Techland inches closer and closer. This second chapter takes place in a more volatile, undead-infested zone, and with its focus on role-playing, it's up to us to make our own choices. These choices will affect the entire course of the game, and will either be beneficial or disadvantageous to your rooftop climbing adventures. It comes out this February 4. Horizon Forbidden West. Forbidden West and Ragnarok are releasing in the same year. If these turn out great, Sony will be breaking record after record. This sequel to Aloy's post-apocalyptic adventures takes her to a new desolate San Francisco. Navigate its treacherous landscapes full of mechanical beasts and use her new tools to her advantage. Coming this February 18. Sifu. Inspired by Jackie Chan and Bruce Lee films, Sifu is a brawler action adventure about a vengeful protagonist. We don't always get kung fu games in the market. The game's developers who previously worked on Absolver managed to create one that's interesting and doesn't feel like a soulless cash grab. It comes out this February 22. Destiny 2, The Witch Queen. The next big expansion from Bungie's Destiny IP. The Witch Queen will unveil a new threat to our Guardians and it will test the foundations of the Light. Packed with a new raid, a new story, and a fancy glaive weapon type, this is considered Destiny's biggest expansion since Forsaken. It comes out this February 22. Elden Ring. FromSoft's most anticipated action-adventure RPG is going to be one of next year's biggest titles. Genre-defining creator Hidetaka Miyazaki borrows inspiration from Breath of the Wild's open world, turning this epic land into a massive exploration adventure. With your pet horse, or whatever that thing is, embark on a grand quest in search of the Elden Ring. It comes out this February 25. Gran Turismo 7. It was only a matter of time before Sony returns to their premier racing game, especially on the new-gen console. Gran Turismo 7 is optimized for the PlayStation 5. Developed by Polyphony Digital, this 8th major installment of the award-winning racing game steers into 2022. It'll take the series to new heights with gorgeous visuals and a ton of customization for hardcore car enthusiasts. Grand Theft Auto 5. It looks like we won't be saying goodbye to Rockstar's open-world action game in the foreseeable future. GTA 5 is back again for the new-gen consoles, notably the PlayStation 5. It comes with a huge performance boost and a visual overhaul. Despite coming out 8 years ago, it still holds up to this day. It comes out in March next year. Marvel's Midnight Suns. An unlikely genre in the superhero formula. It's a tactical RPG set in the dark and brooding side of Marvel Comics. For the first time in a long while, we finally get to step into the shoes of the edgier Marvel characters like Blade and Wolverine. Gameplay involves fighting using deck-building systems and turn-based combat. It comes out in March next year. Cyberpunk 2077. A cautionary tale about game development and overexcited fans. CD Projekt Red's ambitious open-world first-person RPG had a lot of headlines during its launch, and we all know how that turned out. This new-gen upgrade will hopefully fix most of its technical hiccups and add new and meaningful content to the immersive Night City. It comes out early next year. The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, Complete Edition. Cyberpunk isn't the only CD Projekt Red game to get a new gen upgrade next year. Geralt of Rivia's final and massive adventure is also coming out with a performance boost and a visual update. Packed with two of its massive DLCs, Blood and Wine and Hearts of Stone, The Witcher 3 in new gen feels fresh, yet familiar. It comes out the second quarter of next year. Before we continue on with the next exciting game, here's a quick word from our sponsor, Gold Inc. Gold Inc. is a free-to-play, play-to-earn gold mining simulator that you can download right on your phone. Start building your gold mining empire with the 10 million cash you get as capital when you start the game. Use this money to buy excavators, wash plants, security, and everything you need to thrive in the cutthroat gold mining industry. Just like in real-life gold mining, you won't always hit gold, but you can use all the other ores you mine to buy fuel and equipment so you can finally get to the good stuff. And the real fun begins. As a play-to-earn game, you can actually get real-life moolah from playing.
Yeah, boy.
You can find and own claims worth as much as $10 million. That's because the game's currency GXB, which is available on the Apollo wallet, is designed to grow in value every day. If you've already dipped your toes into NFT gaming, you know how valuable it is to get in early. The more players come in, the more competitive it gets. So if you want to start playing today, download Gold Inc. for free. It's available on Android and iOS. Use our code 414-52546 upon signup. Check out the links in our description box. God of War Ragnarok. Kratos and Atreus' next adventure is coming and the realm of the Nordic gods is nearing its end. Ragnarok will take the series to new yet familiar directions. New realms in the Bifrost are open and the father and son duo are facing off against even more dangerous threats. The gameplay is fleshed out with more movements for both Atreus and Kratos. You can even ride Skoll and Hati on a sled. It comes out next year, hopefully. Uncharted: Legacy of Thieves Collection. The full Uncharted experience is coming to the PlayStation 5 next year. All of Nathan Drake's four major adventures and its spin-off involving Chloe Frazier will get the new gen treatment. Like all upgrades to the latest consoles, expect better performance, upscaled visuals, and a few bonus content. Hogwarts Legacy. The magic and mystery of J.K. Rowling's Wizarding World is finally getting an RPG adaptation next year. Explore the hallowed halls of Hogwarts in third person. Customize your own character and embrace the magic of its multiple classrooms. It's the perfect game for anyone who needs to scratch that Pottermore itch. Tom Clancy's The Division Heartland. A free-to-play third-person shooter set in the world of The Division. There's still so much we don't know about Heartland, aside from it being a free-to-play game. It'll also play very similarly to The Division. It was unfortunately delayed to late next year. Suicide Squad: Kill the Justice League. After their famed Arkham trilogy, Rocksteady moves on from the Caped Crusader. This time, take control of four of DC's notorious villains. The major Suicide Squad members, Harley, Deadshot, King Shark, and Captain Boomerang, take on their biggest responsibility yet: stop an evil version of the Justice League. Ghostwire Tokyo. A supernatural action game from the makers of The Evil Within. It takes place in a futuristic Tokyo where everybody seems to have gone from the Rapture. The streets are populated with paranormal entities straight from Japanese legend. It's up to you, a ghost hunter, to fend off these anomalous creatures. It comes out next year. A Plague Tale: Requiem. The follow-up to Asobo Studios' emotional stealth adventure game. As a sequel, expect big-budget set pieces as its two characters escape from the nightmarish moments of Europe's Dark Age. The siblings must make their way through terrible situations and escape from God knows what. The gameplay is still non-existent, but we may see more of it before it comes out next year. Path of Exile 2. This major sequel to the Grinding Gear Games isometric RPG goes crazy with two massive campaigns under one game. It coexists with the original game, so players don't have to worry about starting all over again. This also includes a variety of extra content like equipment, gems, classes, and so much more. Forspoken. Square Enix's ambitious IP that's not Final Fantasy. Dubbed as a AAA isekai, it follows the story of a young girl transported to a magical dimension. Its gameplay involves seamless real-time combat where you manipulate nature like a druid. There's still a lot of questions, but let's hope they'll all get answered before its release next year. Stray, a game about a cat strolling around a bleak cyberpunk society. Yep, that's about it. But Annapurna Interactive did take publishing rights. So even in a puzzle platformer about a walking cat, you can expect thought-provoking themes and new-gen visuals in impressive scale. It comes out next year. Little Devil Inside. An action-adventure that borrows mechanics from Dark Souls and Zelda in a diorama-like perspective. On the outside, it feels like you're watching an interactive version of a Studio Ghibli movie. Its English sensibilities add atmosphere to its ludicrous world packed with hungry creatures and deadly skeletons. The Dark Pictures, The Devil in Me. The next and final chapter for the first season of the Dark Pictures anthology. After House of Ashes' success, it's time Supermassive Games move on to a new story. The Devil in Me's teaser showed a dark and twisted tale about a serial killer in a documentary format. It comes out next year. Rocksmith Plus, Ubisoft's musical learning tool for budding guitar enthusiasts. It offers a subscription-based model similar to Netflix, and it showcases a ton of music for anyone looking to learn how to play the guitar. It's being integrated into their mobile app as well, which will be available once it comes out.